Maple Leafs head coach Sheldon Keefe joins us from Florida, where the team is getting set to face the Panthers on Sunday. Coach, welcome back to Tim and Sid, and thank you very much for doing this.
Yeah, no problem. Thanks for having me.
Let's start with the outdoor practice, Nathan Phillips Square.
Yes.
How was it, and did you have to take the subway, or could you just jump an Uber over?
First of all, I didn't have to take the subway. We were given options to get there, but I thought, much like all of our players, that I thought it was a nice little touch to take the subway and be with the fans and be part of that process. It's always interesting to see people's reactions, to see a bunch of NHL hockey players in full gear walking downtown and through the Eaton Center onto the subway. So it was pretty cool.
Like, a few of the players went old school. Like, I saw some skate guards out there, no?
Yeah, there was a little bit of that. I think the goalies might have had the skate guards going on, but everybody in it, full helmets and gloves and mixing a coffee, a Tim Hortons coffee, just to make it the real real Canadian way. But it was a great time. The players had a lot of fun with it. Fans seemed to enjoy it, and the weather was pretty great, all considering. And it was a fun day for all.
Nice.
Sheldon, it seems like the players have embraced also the way you have approached practice. I mean, we've heard stories of having two different rinks going, five or six coaches on the ice at the same time, the music being played. That's unconventional in today's NHL. I was wondering when along the way you figured that's how you wanted to run some of the off-day stuff and what you're hoping to accomplish by doing it.
I think my time with the Marlies was a good time for me to really experiment with a lot of different things. The number of resources we had there, in terms of coaches and skill coaches with very specific expertise, and then also just the ability at the Ford Performance Center with multiple sheets of ice to do different things and utilize extra space. And in a development program like that, we really got to see the benefits of really having deliberate practice and deliberate skill work to refine the skill sets of the players. I mean, at the end of the NHL, and of course you're dealing with players that have great skills, but even them over the course of the season, I think, require some fine-tuning and the proper repetitions to refine their game in that way. And then also just kind of breaks it up a little bit in terms of the monotony of the schedule and the season. And you're always talking about preaching the same types of things in terms of structure and all of that. And to just sort of break it down a little more individually, I think makes some sense. And the feedback so far has been good on that end.
The run off the top of your tenure was pretty impressive. 15 wins in the first 20 games was a record for a franchise that is over 100 years old. But how happy are you with the play of the team since you took over?
Well, I think I certainly would say I'm happy. The players have responded very well. We've seen a lot of progress in some real key areas, both offensively and defensively and on special teams. So those are, all the areas of the game we've seen progress. I've been happy with it. I've said it a number of times, though, what excites me the most is that we've seen progress. We've been able to have some success and get some positive results from the progress. Yet I still believe there's a lot of room for growth within our team and within the individuals. And that's what's really exciting, just continue to keep working.
Sheldon, I think what a lot of these players are also appreciating is the open line of communication that's gone back and forth and that they know where they stand. I think pro athletes, regardless of sport, tell them the truth, let them know what's going on, let's move on and do what we do. How have you evolved as a coach in that regard when it comes to communicating with players, how to treat players, how to let them know where they stand? Where do you feel you were, say, a stop or two ago in junior to where you are now when it comes to that?
Yeah, you know what? I think that really is an area that I've grown a lot. I certainly know that it's an area that I've spent a lot of time on in terms of reading and talking with different people and attending different conferences and courses and learning about that side of the game and just how much I've come to value that side of it. you know, so much attention, of course, goes on to the tactics and, you know, all the decisions you make as a coach every day in terms of practice and games and bench management and all the like. But really the softer skills when it comes to communication and, you know, creating an environment for players to thrive, that's what I've tried to spend the last number of years on with my own development. And, you know, I like to think I've made some strides there. I'm not perfect by any means, and it is a challenge when you have, you know, upwards of 23 players on your roster to manage, and a lot of staff as well that require managing and communications there. So it's a big part of the job, and that was probably the biggest area of growth for me that I recognized in the early going, just even working with the Marlies, where it takes a lot of management and communication skills. So I think it really is important. It's really become even more prevalent with today's athletes and just the way that the game and sports have evolved, and trying to continue to grow in that area as well for myself.
Yeah, I feel like it's the thing that's changed the most in pro sports over the last 10, 5 years.
Well, especially when you think about today's generation, you know, the millennial, the Gen Z, whatever you want to call it. It's such a different dynamic than it would have been a generation ago.
Yeah, and I think you could see that from having played the game, no, Sheldon?
Yeah, I think so. I've said it to a number of people. I feel like, you know, as a player, I played in the early 2000s and, you know, in the NHL and in the minor leagues. And also, you know, I mean, I look at, there's still some players playing in the league that I played against, and not all that too far removed from it. But at the same time, had the experience of working in at the junior A level, working at the OHL level, working in the American League, coaching in all these various levels, and coming up with a lot of these younger players through their path to getting here, and then work with you know, all sorts of different age groups. So I think those types of things have helped me and provided me with some proper perspective. And then, of course, I've just got an excellent staff around me as well, from management all the way down to our assistant coaching staff and the training staff, equipment staff, all the way through here with the Leafs. We've got some great people.
Sheldon Keefe, the head coach of the Toronto Maple Leafs, joining us here on Tim and Sid with a Rash. Part of the gig in Toronto, and you know this, is that a lot of folks have opinions on your team. One of the biggest opinions that I hear a lot is that you guys need to play a tougher, heavier brand of hockey to be successful in the postseason. Have you and Kyle Dubas decided that you don't necessarily believe in that?
Well, I think there's... When Kyle and I do talk, not just about this team, but when we've worked together previously, you don't for a second disregard the fact that you need to be competitive and you need to have a level of physicality that's going to allow you to be able to, you know, to play the way you want to play, and also to persevere when things are difficult. I think we probably look at toughness in a different manner than others do, and really we would describe it mainly as just the ability to play through difficult circumstances, and that to us is toughness. And we have a high level of skill, and I think we have, well, you know, perhaps other teams would say, you know, we're a really tough and really physical team, but man, I wish we had a little more skill. You know, other teams are saying that, and we're on the other side. We feel like we've got an abundance of skill and the ability to make plays, which ultimately lead to having the puck, which ultimately leads to scoring goals at a high rate. And of course, that is the object of the game ultimately. So that's what we focus on a lot. But we, you know, it doesn't go, or it's not lost on us, the fact that we need to create an environment that encourages our players to be competitive and be themselves when times are most difficult. So that's what we're trying to focus on every day with our guys.
I just need to ask you before we let you go. Martin Marincin got a one-year extension announced today. He's been pretty polarizing among your fans. What do you guys see in him that others don't?
Well, I think what we see in him is just, first of all, he's a guy that's been we're very comfortable with in the organization, and he served the organization very well in his role as a depth defenseman, be it playing in the minors and being a big part of our Calder Cup championship team down there with the Marlies, and being a big part of the development of some of our younger players, and also a guy that's filled in well when needed, when injuries or whatever the situation might be. So you need to have really good depth in the NHL, and you need to have depth that fits in well in the salary cap and the structure, all things that are over my head and things that I'm not overly concerned with, but right. I know from a management level that that's important. And I can also say from my time in the American League that when it comes to players that can play in the American League, but also when you need them, be players that can fill in and play minutes of the NHL, that's extremely valuable. And as I see it from my short time in the NHL, I think Marinson is as good a depth defenseman as there is. So we feel pretty good about that.
Hey, listen, we know it's a couple days off. We really appreciate you taking the time, and hopefully those couple days off in South Florida isn't all video and special teams conversations. So maybe get some time off, enjoy a little bit, but thanks for doing this.
All right, guys. Thank you.